हेलो, हाय एवरीवन, दिस इज योर क्विज मास्टर शौर्य सचदेवा। वेलकम टू द स्पोर्ट्स क्विज, विच इज अ पार्ट ऑफ क्विज फ्रॉम होम 2.0, ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय क्वेस्ट SGGSC, विच इज द क्विजिंग सोसाइटी। एंड लेट्स गेट राइट इनटू इट, स्टार्टिंग ऑफ विद द रूल्स। देयर आर अ टोटल ऑफ 36 क्वेश्चंस इन द सेट। ईच क्वेश्चन इज वर्थ 1 पॉइंट। क्वेश्चन नंबर 6, 12, 18, 24, 30 एंड 36 आर स्टार मार्क क्वेश्चंस which would be used in case of a tie. In case of persistent ties, time will be taken into consideration and answers have to be submitted through the Google Forms on the WhatsApp group. So starting off with the first question. Question number one. In the first ever T20 international match in 2005, Glenn McGrath jokingly bowled an underarm delivery to a Kiwi batsman, Kyle Mills, mimicking Trevor Chappell's notorious delivery 2 decades earlier. What happened next is considered one of the game's most iconic moments. What happened after that? So, yeah, you might have seen something similar in a different sport. That's the only hint I can give. Moving on to the next question. Question number two. In tennis, there were many events where the primitive court has been changed. Like in 2000, ATP used purple courts. US Open in 2005. Changed green courts to blue. Australian Open in 2008 also changed the single tone green to a blue. Likewise, in 2012, the owner and organizer of the Madrid Open decided to make a major change to the existing red clay court. He received a lot of criticism for this decision by the participants as well as the winner. What change is being referred to? Moving on to question number three. Recently, the song X was remixed by Patrice Evra, which he posted on his Twitter handle. Sung by the duo, who agree that they are longtime fans of the club Y, this song in recent years has become an anthem for Y's fans and the team. And the fans can be seen singing the song to cheer the players up. Give X and Y. And you can see the screenshot of Evra's tweet in the next slide. I'll go back to the text. Moving on to the next question. Question number four. Ken is known for his stringent team selection, allowing only those with a certain grade or higher to join his basketball team, and is best known for benching his MVP due to poor academic results. Ken says that carrying the Olympic torch during the 2002 Winter Olympics was his proudest moment. How do we know him better? So try and connect it to a certain pop culture funda, I would say. Moving on to question number five. This American sports equipment manufacturing brand was found in 1979. The brand's initial success came from the innovation of metal drivers and have subsequently dominated the market in other related products as well. The company is believed to be named as a play on a phrase meaning customized, usually used in the apparel industry. The brand was acquired by Salomon Group in 1984, and the ownership was maintained until Adidas bought Salomon in 1997. Identify the brand. So focus on the customized part of the question, that it is a play on the certain phrase. Moving on to the next question. Question number six, which is a star mark question. So you can see a list of players, which includes Phil Alexander, Clive Allen, Jesus Angoy, Manfred Bergsmuller, Silvio De Libretto, Tony Fritsch, Alex Cruz, Tony Linhart, Horst Mullmann, and Neil O'Donoghue. Connect this exhaustive list of footballers based on where they've played. Moving on to question number seven. The Palma Arena is a multi-sport pavilion in Spain. Inaugurated in 2007, it captured global attention as it hosted a tennis match between two of the all-time greats, X and Y. The tennis court for the same required groundsmen to toil for 19 days and costed around $1.63 million. एक्स वन द मैच 7-5, 4-6, 7-6. Though experts claim that the reason why lost was largely due to certain aspects of the court tilting it in X's favor. What was this match called? And identify X and Y. This is a pretty workable question. Moving on to question number 8. This English footballer who recently made his international debut is said to be a distant relative of X. Both share the same surname. Who founded a famous manufacturing company in 1945, and the company had been a subject of memes around 2 years back, especially in India. Identify the player and give X. So the meme might help you work the question. Moving on to question number 9. It is believed that X was played in India as far back as 4,000 years ago. While the origins of the game are still not clear, many believe that the sport was invented by Abhimanyu during the Mahabharata battle at Kurukshetra. X first received international exposure when India demonstrated the sport during the Olympics in 1936. Identify X. You have to identify the sport. Moving on. Question number 10. Central Coast Mariners is an Australian professional football club which competes in the A-League. In 2017, during the regular season, they finished rock bottom. The average attendance at their home stadium was about 7,194. However, in August 2018, during a pre-season friendly against an amateur team, about 10,000 people showed up to the game. What was the reason behind this? Something happened in 2018 which led to a surge in the spectators. You have to give the reason. Moving on. Question number 11. So you can see these four images on the screen and you have to connect them. Try and connect them to a sport. How could they be used in a sport? Moving to question number 12, which is again a star marked question. X was appointed as the project director for FIFA Under 17 World Cup staged in India. This was done keeping in mind his experience of media interactions and the creativity and knowledge of managing events and production in India. X has also previously worked as the team director of one of the IPL teams and is also known for his quizzing skills. You have to identify X. Certain person who worked for the Under 17 World Cup and has also been a team director of one of the IPL teams, one of the more famous IPL teams. Moving on. Question number 13. You can see this image. And what event does this cover of Sports Illustrated depict? Pretty self-explanatory. Moving on to question 14. X is a term frequently used for certain players in this sport. It completely derives its meaning from someone who emerges at the end of the day to protect the important people or things that have significance. Y is a former player who was one of the stars of a fearsome lineup during the late 1990s and early 2000s. He holds the record for being the most successful among the players who came under the category of X in terms of the highest ever score in that role. You have to identify both X and Y. X being a term and Y being a player. Moving ahead. Question number 15. X represented Greenmount Cricket Club in the Bolton Cricket League during the 1980s. He later became a football agent and also acted as the director of Club Bury in the English Football League. Two of his children played football professionally and went on to represent Manchester United at the highest level. The third one became a professional netball player and coach. X is also known for his unusual name. Identify the sporting family or even the surname would work. Focus on the two children who played for Manchester United. It might help you in deriving at the answer. Question number 16. This position requires extensive recruitment and training. Of the approximately 700 people that apply for this position and match the standards, 250 are chosen for probation. Following that, training begins in January. Those who are falling behind will be punished. Though they aren't usually compensated, they do get a little stipend of roughly 200 euros if they perform well. They also get to keep their Ralph Lauren t-shirts. What post am I referring to? The time frame and the t-shirt might be a clue here. Moving on to question number 17. The players couldn't pick each other out. They said it was difficult to see their teammates at a distance when they lifted their heads. It was nothing to do with superstition. What incident is Sir Alex Ferguson referring to, for which Manchester United were also fined by the FA, which Ferguson described as the best £10,000 I ever spent? So this is a quote from Sir Alex Ferguson. You have to identify what he is referring to exactly. What happened? Next is question number 18, which is a star marked question. A particular event that happened on an island led to the displacement of over a million of its inhabitants to different parts of the world. The event was largely blamed on the government's policy of single crop and dependence on capitalism. This led to one of the East Coast cities of the US to be dominated by a certain ethnicity, something which is reflected in the name and mascot of the city's most successful sports franchise. Identify the city as well as the sporting franchise. The influence of the inhabitants from a certain ethnicity would lead you to the answer. Moving on, question 19. X has a somewhat stinky superstition regarding the socks worn at tournaments and will continue to wear the same pair of unwashed socks as long as X keeps winning until the end of the tournament. This isn't the only foot related superstition, as X has also developed a superstition about the way of tying the shoelaces, and in the past has even chalked up certain losses to not tying the shoes correctly, saying, "I'm not losing because I didn't play well. I lost because I didn't tie my shoelaces the right way." Identify X. Whose superstitions are we talking about? A pretty famous athlete. Moving on to question number 20. So you can see six images on your screen, five images actually, and you have to identify the missing player and the connect between them. The arrows might help. Moving on to question number 21. We met at our coaching classes and our friendship blossomed into more. But there was one issue, that I am from Haryana and he is from Hyderabad, and inter-community are quite rare in our country, which is why we had to hide our relationship for the longest time of 10 years. Identify the pair, both of whom went to achieve great individual success at the same sport. There is a quote from a certain athlete, and you have to identify the couple that they are referring to. Moving on to question 22. What five-word phrase was used to advertise these Converse sneakers, since it was endorsed by a popular NBA player of the time? Most of us are familiar with this phrase as an idiom, meaning exactly what is needed or wanted. You can see the image on the next slide. I'll go back to the text. If you try and identify the player who is advertising these sneakers, that might lead you to the phrase. Question number 23. At UFC 117, MMA fans around the world witnessed Cale Sonnen put a beatdown on longtime champion Anderson Silva before ultimately succumbing to a triangle choke halfway through the final round. Silva left that night with his middleweight title strapped firmly around his waist. In a press conference that was organized by Fox 2, Sonnen did something that struck fans as rather odd. What did he do? Moving on to question 24, which is a star mark question. X uses this phrase in training to motivate the team whenever he thinks that his players are sleeping. Gianfranco Zola, who played under X at Napoli and Chelsea, says, "Dash, dash, dash, dash. It goes a long way back to the times of Napoli. X has always been very, very colorful when he speaks to the dressing room. When I first heard it, I knew exactly what he meant. Dash, 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 dash. He told me this so many times. Sometimes as a player, you just need a wake-up call because concentration is so important in football. Identify the manager X and the phrase which has also been used by him in various press conferences." It is a very famous phrase used by this particular manager who recently made a comeback into something. So that's a hint. Moving on to question 25. This was a spin-off of a more popular cycling event. It took place in three Indian cities in 2012 and 2013. The first edition was held in Mumbai, Srinagar and Delhi in 2012, and the second edition was held in Mumbai, Jaipur and Delhi in 2013. John Abraham was its brand ambassador in the year 2013. The categories of the event were full, half, green, champions and international. Which event are we talking about? Which is one of a very popular cycling event. So, moving on to question 26. England, Young England, Australia, Jamaica, Trinidad and Tobago, New Zealand, and International 11. This is a list of the teams that participated in the inaugural edition of a tournament. You have to identify the tournament. The list might seem a little odd, and another hint is that the tournament took place in the 1970s. Moving on to question 27. X is a particular happening in tennis whose frequency increased astronomically since the early 2000s. It attracts varying degrees of reactions depending upon what tournament a player has committed it in, and at times might even lead to permanent termination of membership at a particular tennis club. Identify X and the specific tennis club. So this particular reaction that has increased in tennis since the 2000s. Identify X and the tennis club. Question number 28. This four-word expression, which means to be in trouble or to be in an awkward position or to be out of luck, is believed to have originated from a tricky pool situation. In snooker, getting snookered is a comparable expression. What is the idiom being talked about? So you have to identify this idiom or phrase which has originated from a particular situation in a game of pool, which most of you might have been in. Moving on to question number 29. Brando's is an international restaurant chain founded in 1987, which now has about 1,000 outlets in 30 plus countries. In honor of a certain individual's retirement, Brando's declared that all of its restaurants in the city of X will close at 11.05 p.m. rather than the normal 11 p.m. What is the two-word term or give funda behind closing 5 minutes after the usual closing time? Something which rivals often complained about. So, yeah, on this particular day, the restaurants closed 5 minutes late. So you have to give the funda or the two-word term. Moving on, question number 30, which is a star mark question. This photo is from an event that was organized in 1967, featuring four all-time greats: Bill Russell, Muhammad Ali, Jim Brown, and Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. The four legends were seated and got the most attention, but the men standing behind them were other prominent black athletes, including Pro Football Hall of Famers Bobby Mitchell and Willie. What was the name given to it and why was it organized? The image is on the next slide. I'll go back to the text. You have to give the name of the event and the reason behind organizing it. Moving on, question number 31. In a post-fight interview following UFC 261, Kamaru Usman was asked why he chose to inflict further damage on an already downed opponent. According to Usman, those punches were super necessary. What was the reason behind choosing these particular words? Yeah, there's a kind of a backstory behind these words and you have to give the reason why he chose these. Moving ahead, question number 32. Crystal Palace, 1997-98, Ipswich Town, 2001-2002, Birmingham City, 2010-11, and Wigan Athletic, 2012-13. You have to connect these football clubs to a certain thing that they've achieved in the mentioned seasons. Moving on to question number 33. X is an annual tradition and is thought to have first been played in 1979 as part of a Mexican fiesta. It is played in one of the most secured and regulated regions of the world. What is the nine-letter variant, which is a wordplay on the original sport and the net being used in the sport? So this is an event which takes place in one of the most secure regions and is a wordplay on another very popular sport, which all of you might be aware of. Moving on to question number 34.
Hi, Lightning McQueen told me this was the best place in the world to get tires. How about setting me and my friends up with 3 or 4 sets each?
So this is someone's cameo appearance in this particular movie. And you have to identify whose cameo is this. I'll play the video again.
Ciao. Hi, Lightning McQueen told me this was the best place in the world to get tires. How about setting me and my friends up with 3 or 4 sets each?
Yeah, moving on to question 35. X was a first round pick in the MLB draft by the Mets, but his playing career fell short of the scouts' expectations, who believed he was supposed to be a star. During his time at the front office of the Oakland Athletics, X used statistical analysis, also known as sabermetrics, to assess players, which has caused all teams to reconsider how they evaluate players. He was the subject of a baseball economics book published in 2003. He also claimed that Arsene Wenger, the former Arsenal coach, is a personal idol of his. Identify X and name the book. There are enough hints in the question. And yeah, name the book and X. Moving on to the last question of the quiz, question number 36, which is again a star marked question. Given in the photograph are the past and present jerseys of a Brazilian club playing in Series B, second division in Brazil. Traditionally, their jersey featured 4 red strips along with black. But with the club's recent marketing campaign for a certain cause, it led to the removal of the red stripes with a system built to restore them on their kit step by step. What is the way to restore the red stripes as said by the club? So I'll show you the image on the next slide. The one on the left is the original jersey and the one on the right is the new jersey, part of the marketing campaign mentioned in the question. I'll go back to the text. Identify the way to restore the red stripes. And that is it. Thank you all for participating in the sports quiz. And the Google Forms will be closed shortly. Thank you so much.